I became familiar with Friendship Circle a number of years ago when a good friend of ours had a grandchild who had some severe health problems, and Friendship Circle was involved in caring for the family. We had a number of friends, Barbara and I, who volunteered here, and we hadn't seen Lifetown. We didn't know what it was, and when we visited, we just got blown away. And Barbara said, you know, I think I would like to volunteer here. She never had the feeling of doing something good as she had when she worked here, and she was in the dental office, and she was in the bank, and she was in the beauty parlor, and the beaming of the young children when they got their nails polished, it just gave her such joy, like nothing she had ever done before. She was really fit to be a teacher, particularly of young children. She had a gift of seeing the world and seeing events through the eyes of a child. After Barbara passed away, I started to think about things that I could do in her honor and the honor of her memory that she would have been pleased with. One of the things that Barbara loved in life, and especially about being Jewish, was Shabbat. As the week wore on, she reminded the kids, Shabbos is coming, and I'm gonna have a surprise. The children just all week long talked about and were waiting for Shabbat. And after she passed away, I started to think about, well, what could I do to perpetuate her memory? That gave rise to Fabulous Friday. When I've come to Fabulous Fridays, I've been convinced that it was the right thing to do. I mean, Barbara would just have adored looking around the room and seeing happy faces. I received many, many letters from former students of hers, and they talk about her smile and her kindness. Those words at the footstone that we created for her grave, I didn't want to put down the usual loving grandma, mother, wife, etc. It reads, Nana's smile lit up every room. Her kindness warmed every heart. She just had this beautiful presence, and as a teacher and a lover of children, and her ability to see the world through youngsters' eyes, she got that at Lifetown, and she couldn't have gotten it in any other place.
Pa, congratulations on this special honor. We love you.
Congratulations, Pa, Mazal Tov. I'm so proud of you for this honor and all the work you do to help the amazing projects at Lifetown. And I'm so sorry I can't be there with you in person, but I hope you know that I'm there with you in spirit. And Nana would be so proud of all the work and love and continued care and support you've shown for this amazing organization. And I know for sure she's here with you today and every day.
Hi, Pa. We're so proud of you and your work with Lifetown and how it carries on Nana's work with them and how much she loved them. We love you and we just want to wish you the best.
Love you.
Pa, ever since I can remember, you and Nana taught us, your kids and grandkids, to seek out people and organizations that are doing amazing things in the world and then do what you can to support them in their efforts. That is exactly what you have done for Lifetown, a phenomenal organization that does so much for everyone who gets to walk through the doors, including Nana, who savored every moment of her time volunteering there. Mazal tov on this honor. I'm so lucky to call you as my own and grateful to be able to share you with the community who appreciates all that you do. I love you.
Love you.